Hi everybody, today is February 9th, 2013. Japan suggests hotline to Beijing over island spat. Kind of reminds me of the Cold War eras when Washington had one with Russia. Japan has suggested setting up a military hotline with China to avoid clashes between the two countries, which are at loggerheads over a group of disputed islands, Tokyo Defense Ministry said on Saturday. The proposal came after Tokyo accused a Chinese frigate of locking its weapon tracking radar on a Japanese destroyer, a claim Beijing has denied. The incident, which Japan said happened last week, marked the first time the two nations' navies have locked horns in a territorial dispute that provoked fears of armed conflict breaking out between the two. The neighbors, also the world's second and third largest economies, have seen ties sour over the uninhabited Japanese-controlled islands in the East China Sea, known as the Seikoku in Tokyo and Diu in Beijing, which also claims them. What's important is to create a hotline so that we would be able to communicate swiftly when this kind of incident happens, Defense Minister told reporters. He said Tokyo told Beijing on Thursday through its embassy in China that it wants to resume talks on creating a seaborne communication mechanism between military officials of both countries. In 2010, China and Japan agreed to establish a hotline between political leaders following a series of naval incidents, but the plan has yet to materialize. Defense officials of the two countries also agreed in 2011 to set up a military-to-military hotline by the end of last year, but the talks stalled due to heightened tensions over the territorial realm. Onuero also said Japan was considering disclosing evidence to bolster its accusation of the lock-on incident after Beijing rejected the charge. We have evidence. The government is considering the extent of what can be disclosed because it includes confidential information on Japan's defense capabilities, Onuera said. The comments came after Prime Minister Shinzo Abe demanded Beijing apologize and admit the incident took place. Tokyo has also charged that last month a Chinese frigate radar locked on a Japanese helicopter in a procedure known as painting that is a precursor to firing weaponry. For both alleged incidents on January 19th and January 30th, Chinese Defense Ministry said in a statement to AFP that the Chinese shipboard radar maintained normal operation and fire control radar was not used. On order said on Saturday that Japan could prove the frigate used a fire control radar instead of an early warning radar that China insists was used as part of normal operations. An early warning radar turns around repeatedly, while a fire control radar keeps pointing to a moving ship that it targets at, Oneida said. We have evidence that the radar followed after our ship for a certain period of time, he said, adding that Japan recorded a radio frequency that is particular to a fire control radar. The long-running row over the islands intensified in September when Tokyo nationalized part of the chain, triggering fury in Beijing and huge anti-Japan demonstrations across China. Beijing has repeatedly sent ships and aircraft near the islands, and both sides have scrambled fighter jets, though there have been no clashes. Activities of Chinese official ships around the Seikoku Islands have claimed since Tuesday, when Japan disclosed the radar incident, Onodera said. Abe, the hawkish Japanese premier, on Thursday called the incident extremely regrettable, dangerous, and provocative, but also said dialogue must remain an option. So that's interesting that they want a hotline between the two countries. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.